Hello, not so long ago, YouTube user CrabMeat88 asked me to show how to make Canadian flag. So that's what we are going to make today, flag of Canada. Inflate white balloon leaving about 9 inch flat tail. We're going to twist all bubbles of the same size, up to 1 inch. Twist a chain of first 5 bubbles. We are going to twist total of 24 white bubbles to make a rectangle with sides 6 by 4 bubbles. Here I have made a chain of first 5 bubbles. Let's lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. Now we twist a chain of the next 6 white bubbles. We are working this rectangle from the center, and that's where we're going to finish, at the center of the rectangle. There are different ways to make the same sculpture. In this example, we are making first the bigger white rectangle, and then we will attach 2 smaller red rectangles to the sides of the white rectangle. Now let's lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 12th bubble. Now we lock both ends of the chain of the first 12 bubbles in one lock twist. Now let's twist a chain of the next 2 white rectangles. And then we are going to lock both ends of the chain of the last 12 bubbles in one lock twist. We have to pull the end of the white balloon through the loop of 4 white bubbles. Push the end of the balloon through the loop of bubbles in the same direction as you twist the bubbles. This way you avoid untwisting bubbles. Twist a chain of the next 3 white bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 white bubbles in one lock twist. So far we have made almost 3/4 of the white rectangle. Let's twist a chain of the next 5 white bubbles. I have described another way of making the same sculpture in my blog post. Over there I work white and red rectangles at the same time. It seems easier for me, at least, to attach rectangles to each other. Otherwise, there is not much differences. And now we lock both ends of the chain of the last 12 white bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the next 23rd white bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 white bubbles in one lock twist. And finally, we twist the last 24th white bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 24 white bubbles in one lock twist. Once again, we started the sculpture from the center, and we finish it at the same spot in the center of the rectangle. Oops, 2 bubbles untwisted. Have to twist them back. Not a big deal. Okay, we have made white rectangle with sides 6 by 4 bubbles. We can cut off the rest of the white balloon and tie off the ends. I'm gonna keep it for now. Now we're going to use red balloons to make smaller red rectangles with sides 6 by 2 bubbles. We attach red rectangles to the long sides of a white rectangle. We're going to twist 12 red bubbles to make one small red rectangle. Twist a chain of first 2 red bubbles. Lock the free end of the second red bubble between 2 white bubbles at the corner on the long side of the white rectangle. In this example, it is the second and third white bubbles. Tie the nozzle of the red balloon between the nearest 2 white bubbles. Twist a chain of the next 3 red bubbles. Luck boss ends of the chain of the last four red bubbles in one luck twist. As you already can see, we work the red rectangle basically in the same fashion as we did the white rectangle previously. The only difference here, we are touching rectangles to each other. That's all. Twist a chain of the next five red bubbles. Also, I think it's worth to mention that it could be a bit a challenge to make a chain of 24 bubbles. It's definitely harder than twist a chain of 12 bubbles, especially for beginners. That's why I start the sculpture by making big 24 bubbles rectangle. Lock the free end of the last red bubble between two white bubbles, located at the other corner of the same long side of white rectangle. Now we have to twist the 11th red bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last four red bubbles in one lock twist. Alright, let's twist the 12th red bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 12 red bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the first red rectangle with sides 6 by 2 bubbles. Let's cut off the rest of the red balloon, tie off the ends. You can use scissors to cut off the balloon. Alright, we have made two rectangles connected to each other. At this point, our sculpture actually has a square shape with sides 6 by 6 bubbles. Now we are going to make the second red rectangle, the same size, 6 by 2 bubbles. And we attach the red rectangle to the other long side of the white rectangle. We are going to work the rest of the sculpture in exactly the same fashion as we worked previously. I'm going to first play this part of the video to save your time. I guess there is no need to explain the same thing over and over again, right? Think I forgot to mention, we can use the scrap of the first red balloon to make the second red rectangle. It may seem not as much of importance. It saves you just a dime. But you have to make all 24 bubbles of exactly the same size. That's what counts. Okay, we have made the second red rectangle. Our sculpture has rectangular shape with sides 6 by 8 bubbles. Let's cut off the rest of the white balloon and tie off the ends. Now I'm going to use a permanent red marker to draw the symbol on Canadian flag. First I outline the symbol and then I color it. Have to admit, as a painter I have very loose hand. Hopefully you can do better than me. Here is the outlined symbol and now I just color it inside. So it is the smallest variation of Canadian flag that I so far come up with. Obviously, with small balloons we can make bigger size flag. In the future, we may try to make a larger size flag and even use balloons to make the symbol. Though I think it will work only on very large size sculpture. Congratulations, we have made flag of Canada. Have fun and happy twisting.